This is Mark Bell, and I'm here today with my buddy,
my pal, Silent Mike. That's me. What's going on, guys?
It's at Silent Mike with two K's on the Instagram.
Go just follow us. It's not a big deal.
We're doing some voiceover work here today for...
Whoa, do you see those dance moves?
This video that we did with Misa Bakwan. And we're using the hip circle to warm up, and this is formally how you do hip circling.
Everyone always asks us how we warm up, and the truth be told, that's how we do it every single day at Super Training. Hip circle, dance, and then the actual hip circle.
Here we are getting a little bit of warm up in with Bart Kwan and Gio from Barbell Brigade. If you ever have a chance, if you're ever in Los Angeles, make sure you try to check out their gym. They got an awesome gym. Here's Nadine, the African Dream, jumping in with us here. You can see everyone has these fancy blue knee sleeves on their legs. Those, I just made them wear them because
that's we can't talk about it.
That's what we do here at Super Training. Make people wear shit they don't want to wear.
But everybody, or not everybody, but Gio hit a PR, I think. Everybody else was just kind of hitting some reps.
You're going to notice everybody's got a little bit different form. Gio's got the bar fairly low. Misa Bakwan has the bar fairly low as well. He's going with Olympic shoes. One thing I learned, I just went to a seminar with Mikhail Kokilev and Boris Shako. And one thing that we're always trying to do as American lifters is we're just always trying to lift so hard and lift so fast. And it really just helped me realize that I just need to kind of slow some shit down and not be in such a rush. And so that's what I'm going to help try to promote to other people.
Yeah, I've kind of done a good job of that in my past, I think, with my squat. You know, I lift in maybe the 80% range. I try to be more controlled, and then my squats, you know, form-wise and health-wise, are one of my better lifts. But deadlift and bench, you know, you get excited and you just start lifting heavy weights, but it's not always best for your career or your strength.
Yeah, deadlift, you just kind of want to yank on the bar, especially like when it's just feeling heavy. You're just, like, not sure what the hell to do. Gio is probably about... 5'11"?
Yeah, I think she's taller than me. Long legs, long torso.
Long legs. Extra long legs that just go on and on and on.
Just a bunch of perverts in the comment section right now.
So supple.
Yes, but she moves pretty good for how tall she is and how slim she is. A lot of girls, you know, they have a problem kind of coordinating their hips and knees on the squat. They don't know which ones to go. And I think the main thing Mark kind of told Gio, and we helped her with just allowing her body to lean over just a little bit, allowing herself to use her low back out of the hole a little bit, like Mr. Ed Cohn did, and he preaches a lot that it's okay if you fold over a little bit. It's not going to be the end of the world. Just make sure that you're pushing back up into that bar with your traps.
Yeah, and you know, there's going to be differences in positioning as the weights get a little heavier, and for someone like Bart, he tends to shoot a little bit forward. The bar tends to kind of roll on him a little bit. If you can try to just find a position, you can see I got my hands on the bar there. With Nadine just trying to roll the bar up a little bit because he's got the bar down just super, super low.
He had it lower than like a 100-pound chick. Yeah. Some of those girls wedge it way down there. He was doing that.
I don't even know what it was resting on.
He's a strong kid, by the way. He's maybe 19, I think. Squatted about 565 last time I was down there with me,
damn,
Omar, and... Furious Pete. We're all squatting together. He smashed some big weights.
But one of the main things is just to try to maintain position. Try not to get the bar or try not to do anything so crazy with your body that your body reverts back to doing something strange. So if the bar is too low, a lot of times the bar is going to want to roll up on your back. If the bar is too high, the bar might want to slide down your back. If you're trying to overarch too much, a lot of times you're going to crumble and round over. So you got to try to find something, a happy medium between what is correct form and what your body's actually capable of doing.
Gio just turned up her jam. I forgot what it was, but I think this might be a PR triple for her. I want to say her best is around 225 pounds, and this might be around 210. The bar is about 55 pounds or so, and she hit it for a pretty clean triple.
I think we forced her to do another set here coming up too, mainly just because she's so hot and we just wanted to see her keep lifting.
Yeah, on the camera, you guys probably want less of us and more of her, so we kept it going.
Her Instagram, I think, has like 225,000.
Yeah, she smashes us all.
Followers. She's a stud.
Oh, Bakwan.
But these two are awesome. Awesome people to be around. They run Barbell Brigade together as well as JK Films and a bunch of other projects they always have going on. They're always doing something. They do podcasts together. They do YouTube videos together where they talk about relationships and stuff like that.
They have a full clothing line. I think they're kind of the real... Oh, man, we were jammed today. I think it was they're the real kind of definition of entrepreneurs, you know? They're trying to get their hands in a lot of things. They're not afraid to fail, and they're just kind of going after it. Who's that fat guy?
Oh, my God. You can see I got that wide base with the hands. That's not something I love doing, but that's just kind of where my hands go. So I'm working on trying to bring them in as of late to get a tighter upper back position.
Yeah, you guys will check out Mark Smelly Bell's Instagram, and his squats are looking a lot better, actually. He's looking a lot more upright. I think he moved his stance in a little bit, bar a little bit lower. Both of us are working a lot on kind of bracing. You know, Mark especially has been lifting forever, but I've been lifting a good while, and we always know kind of take a deep breath, but everyone's preaching to us. You know, Chris Duffin, Chad Wesley Smith, different techniques to just get as tight as you possibly can. Really lock in your spine.
It takes a lot of dedication. It takes a long time to really build up the strength that's necessary to be like truly strong. And then on top of that, to really try to ever master the technique is, only happens amongst the cream of the crop. Mastering technique along with moving heavy weight. You might see some people that have great technique and great form, but it's usually guys that are lifting much less weight. It's really rare to see somebody, picking up a 900-pound deadlift with quote-unquote good form.
Yeah, there's three kind of ways to get strong, right? Getting better at the movement, techniques, such like that. Actually getting stronger, which is, fibers firing faster, blah, 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 more sciencey nerd stuff. And then growing muscle, So I think you should somehow make all three a goal every session you have. Work on something with your technique. Try to get some work in to build muscle. Trying to get some technique work in to get better and better at your skill.
Yeah, unfortunately, you got to focus on all of it. You have to focus on here, and even right here, Gio's been...
It's kind of weird you guys are looking at my Instagram mid-workout.
Yeah. Look at that picture of Silent Mike Wiener. It's something that has to be worked on all the time. Doesn't matter how long you've been in the game for. You're going to always have to try to refine stuff, reinvent yourself. You're going to have to, lose weight, gain weight. You're going to have to do all sorts of different things. I think Mike is trending upward now with his body weight.
Trending upward.
After losing some weight, it's because you got to change. You got to change things. There's no other way around it. And especially as a natty lifter, I think it's even more important to go through different phases for different reasons.
I wasn't gonna play the natty card, but I think as a smaller person, or a little bit, I guess I'm technically I'm middleweight, but whatever. It's really hard to stay fairly lean and get a lot stronger and make the progress you want. So you kind of take everything in phases, Periodize if you'd like.
Look at that hat.
Look at that outfit.
Sick ass.
Black on black on black. With the swagged out socks. $20 socks.
Damn, son.
I'm wearing lady shoes.
Oh yeah, the lady Reebok.
Dude, the best colorway Reebok makes.
Yeah.
Gotta get the ladies' kicks.
Fancy laces.
Yeah. Tennis ball laces. I think we're worked up to maybe about 4 plates, all of us or so. Maybe Smelly went up to about 4.25.
See, Nadim again with that low bar position. If you can figure out how to get the bar there, that's not a bad way to do things.
Yeah, and like Mark mentioned earlier, he did move it up. Before, he had it way in his wrists, and his wrists were way cocked back. Now Nadim has it maybe a half an inch up on his back, but his wrists are a little bit straighter, probably allowing him to hold that bar position and not let it roll.
You want to be able to have control. That's always the main thing, is that you're able to control it. So, whatever hand positioning is comfortable for you, wherever you can get it on your shoulders is fine. But in general, we see the biggest squats usually done by guys that have the bar low, kind of like what Bart has there.
Yeah, Bart stays in a pretty good position the whole time. His back gets a little arched, I think, and then also he really starts to break at his knees, which may pitch him forward. Like Mark mentioned earlier, sometimes he may get pitched a little forward.
I think sometimes what happens with some of these guys is they are trying to keep the bar really low on their back. But then they're also trying to stay upright. And those are two things that don't really go together that well. The upright position that you see has been truly mastered by Olympic lifters. They're the ones that are able to be straight up and down, but they also have the bar legitimately just kind of right on the back of their neck, which kind of helps push them straight down into the squat.
Right. We don't like to distinguish all that much high bar, low bar, and the different things, but stereotypically, stereotypically, bar really high, your torso is going to stay upright, knees are going to travel forward a bit more.
Oh, my God.
Oh, maybe you worked up to 5 plates with a little giggle.
Yeah, that was terrible. I like cut it a little bit. It got all sideways. I don't know what's going on.
We're jamming to some kind of, I forgot what kind of music.
Yeah.
EDM, as the kids call it.
I think it was Gio's
yeah.
shit she was playing, right?
Yeah, it was Gio's mix.
Wah, 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 wah.
Yeah. All that techno stuff. DJ Gio.
Gio, every time like somebody said something that she thought was of importance, she like she did a little sound effects for us.
She's a lifetime hype man. Anything you do, just day-to-day stuff, she's hyping you up, building you up.
Like if Mike came in here today and he's like, oh, I lost 3 pounds overnight, yeah. getting ripped. She'd be like...
The Brazilian techno horns.
She kind of did that throughout the gym, too. She's like looking at the different signage on the wall and stuff. She kept doing the different hype music.
And here goes... if you guys don't know what the hell we're talking about, go check out Mark Bell's PowerCast on iTunes. That'll give you a little insight to maybe what happened.
Killing it.
Hey, what are we at? Maybe 450 or so. Maybe a little bit more. Banging out some reps.
This guy does all the filming for Mista Bakwan, for Barbell Brigade. I don't know if he does any of the JK stuff.
I think he's the Barbell Brigade film guy.
Woo!
Gio squeaking one out.
You see how much work we're getting in on this day. We just kept going. And then by the time we got done with squats, you guys will see here in a second, we're pretty grizzled.
Yeah, Bart, I think, wanted to deadlift. It was supposed to be his deadlift day, but we didn't care, so we made him squat. And then we tried to deadlift, and we were all just exhausted.
I never knew Bart was a gangster. Did you know that?
Gangsta Bart.
Damn, it must be hard being a gangster.
I think he's a self-proclaimed fake gangster.
Yeah. He doesn't look that scary. He does have tattoos, though.
He has a few tattoos. He's got some muscles on him.
He's got some guns and stuff.
Yeah, he's got a big chest.
Mm-hmm.
Big guns. Wowee, Bart Kwan.
Whoa. Damn shrugs.
What is that, 225?
Easy.
Wah, wah, wah. Yeah, she's cheering us on.
Cheerleader. Saw the mic stretching out the pecs in between sets.
Yeah, I was doing a pec deck in between.
It's a
superset.
Post-tectonic facilitation of the pectoral muscles in between in between deadlifting sets.
I might be wrong, but I think you just called my pecs like platonic plates or something. Yeah, San Andreas, something like that. What are they doing?
Just a shot of Gio looking hot.
I think they're just listening to you.
Bart is confused.
Yeah, Gio has a pretty strong pull. I think she's pulled well over 300, but she gets really roundy off the ground. I think that's pretty common with a ton of lifters is they think the deadlift is simply lifting the bar up. But since the bar is not on your back in the squat, like the squat, or in your hands like the bench, it's harder to find the sensation of tightness. So you really have to get as tight and wound up as you can off the ground. Packing your lats, that means pulling the bar into your shins, squeezing your abs down, big breath into your lower gut until your face wants to explode, and then you can kind of pull off the ground and your back won't round and your bar path will hopefully be straight.
And you can see for some of us, you know, right here, you're not seeing a lot of that stuff manifest itself, but as you get heavier in weight is when you're going to see more and more of it. And we work a lot with Gio on this particular day to really help her try to solve that problem because she's a strong girl. I think she's deadlifting well over 300 pounds sumo. But you can kind of see here the execution of her lift is just not on point with where it should be. So we had her raise her hips up a little bit. So she's not, if you look at the belt, every time she deadlifts, she like pushes out into the belt with her lower back, which is definitely not something that you want to do on every single deadlift.
Yeah, maybe max effort, things might get a little weird, but a lot of guys say that, you know, maybe it shouldn't even get weird on your max effort if you practice correctly. I think the thing lies is, yeah, she's just so long, her torso so long, so we got to get her into that right position. I think Mark's showing her here, you know, the shoulder position over the bar, and the sumo should almost be directly over the bar. You start pulling that bar into your body, flexes your lats, you kind of straighten out your back a little bit, and then you're really packed in to maintain a neutral spine through the whole lift.
Yeah, in a sumo deadlift, you're trying to get, you know, as upright as you can, but within reason also. You know, you get too upright, and then you're just squatting the weight off the floor, which becomes, you know, feels nearly impossible. Kills your hips. And then on top of that, the range of motion's actually increased a little bit because you got your hips down so low. So, you got to try to find a position that's going to work well for you. I think here we might have started to have a...
Yeah,
working on a couple different things. I know we talked to her about some stiff leg deadlifts. I think right here what I'm trying to ask you to do is stay tight even on the way down. That's something that Mikhail Kokulev shared in his seminar.
Ed Cohn mentioned also.
Yeah, it's part of the lift. the eccentric portion of the deadlift as part of the lift is going to help build muscle, help build strength. Why not just do it, you know? Here's Silent Mike.
Yeah, Barquan was asking me about my arms, and he wanted to touch them, and for some reason, Moneymaker Mike got it on camera.
He's so jacked, that Silent Mike. Strength is never weakness, and that is it from us. Later.